right, Matt, tell us, what is your role here on the cruise?
So I'm the operations manager here at Lake Pleasant Cruises, and I am also the captain. I'm our main captain, so I'll drive most of the cruises. And we do a few different cruises. I do our daily sightseeing cruises, which tour around the lake for 90 minutes, and I'll do a commentary, talk about Arizona and Lake Pleasant and some of the facts of the area. It's a lot of fun. Those go for 90 minutes. And we also have music cruises, which will cruise around for a couple hours at sunset. Dinner cruises as well, which are 2 hours, and those are a lot of fun. We'll have dinner served downstairs, live music on top of the boat. And those are our cruises that we offer.
Okay, and how many cruises have you done so far?
You mean this year or so far?
In general.
I've been driving the boat for about a year now, so we've done cruises 4 days a week for most of that time period, and then we just started doing cruises 7 days a week, starting last week and starting February 1st. And so now we do those daily sightseeing cruises once a day, 7 days a week, and then we'll do music cruises and dinner cruises on most weekends.
What is your favorite part about being a captain?
I just love getting to drive the boat, be on the water. It's in the middle of the desert, and getting to be out on the lake, it's a pretty great spot to be. Not very many people get to hang out on the water in the desert. And it's great to get to talk to people. A lot of nice people come out here, and it's a great time.
Departing daily from Pleasant Harbor Marina, Lake Pleasant Sightseeing Cruises offer a front row seat to spectacular Arizona scenery. The cruise boat called the Phoenix has been operating on Lake Pleasant since 2014. The boat that seats up to 150 people is climate controlled and offers a full bar and a snack menu. While enjoying the scenery with a cold drink or a snack in your hand, you will get to learn some interesting facts about Arizona, history of the lake, and also you will get to see some wildlife. Matt, who is the operations manager and the captain of the boat, tells me that his favorite part about being the captain is being on the water in the middle of the desert and getting to hang out with nice people. Daily cruises are family friendly and are great for the little ones, as they will get to meet the captain and even drive the boat. Caitlin, who is the marketing manager for Lake Pleasant Cruises, tells me that while most cruises are all ages, there are some cruises that are 18 and up. She also tells me that they host special holiday cruises such as St. Patty's Day, Halloween, and Valentine's Day. Caitlin tells me that while no proposals happen on the boat, they have done quite a few weddings and many special events. For Cronkite News, I'm Shaha Mustafik reporting.
If you do need anything while on board today, please don't hesitate to ask one of them. A couple of heads located downstairs at the back of the boat. And for those of you that do not know, heads is the nautical term for the restroom. We do have two different ones down there. They are labeled male and female. However, they are pretty much identical. So if one is taken, you are welcome to use the other one. The bar downstairs is open and Diane is serving up some good drinks. We have a couple of different drink specials that she's serving, a couple of different huckleberry drinks and a peach drink and a rum fruit punch. They are all very delicious. I should know, I've had one of each today. Just kidding, I like to stick with beer when I know I have to drive. We are all set to take off, so I will be sounding the horn to alert other boats that we are leaving the dock. It can be pretty loud for those of you towards the front end of the boat, so if you would like to cover your ears, now would be your chance. And we will be on our way. Once again, welcome aboard. Smoking on the boat. We do have fire extinguishers located throughout the boat, so if you do see anyone smoking, feel free to grab one of those and use it. And rule number three, Arizona state law requires all children 12 and under to wear a life jacket while on board. In the case of an emergency, all life jackets are located on the top deck in the white containers, two at the back of the boat and two at the front. And if you would feel more comfortable, you're definitely welcome to grab one of those and keep it with you throughout the cruise. However, you will not be needing it today. I'm going to tell you a little bit about the boat that we are 150 miles with police escorts the entire way. Everything you see on the top deck, including the railings, wheelhouse, and canopy, were all added after the boat arrived here at Lake Pleasant so that we would have proper clearance for the drive down. The Phoenix is powered by two 250-horsepower Volga Penta diesel engines with a 25,000-watt generator. She is 65 feet long and 23 feet wide and can carry up to 150 passengers. Today's cruise will take us about 12 miles along the beautiful shorelines of Lake Pleasant, where I'll be sharing some facts about Arizona, the Sonoran Desert, and the Agua Fria Valley. Seven times better than a bloodhound. who smells 10 times better than the average dog, which smells 100 times better than a human 3 miles away. One of the lizards. It is one of only two venomous types of lizards in the world. They are in the springtime during the day and they come out in the mornings. The human monster can survive on its fat or stored energy for about 3 months. And they have very strong jaws and venom that can be released through their bottom teeth. The bottom teeth are large and they are capable of jumping over fences as high as 8 feet. So it is pretty tricky to keep them out of your backyard. Capacity. We are 1,702 feet above sea level. You can see where that 100% watermark is at on those rocks when they change from a dark to light color. And as you can see, we're still down quite a ways from being full. They are currently filling the lake and will usually reach 100% capacity around the end of March or beginning of April. The smallest desert mammals we have out here is the kangaroo rat. This is the rat's pocket. Kangaroo rats are also very quick and they get their name from their ability to jump up to 9 feet at a time. Some of the birds you might see flying around this area include hummingbirds, mourning doves, vultures, hawks, ravens, Arizona State bird, the cactus wren. And to head out to our right, you can follow the way back that direction for about a mile. We've reached the mouth of the Agua Fria River. It is currently closed as to have running around the desert here, and I say running, not flying, because that is the road runner, which actually spends most of its life on the ground and running to get directly. It's actually less strenuous on the bird, requires less energy than flying, allowing the road runner to conserve the water, which is very important here in the desert. And the reason I didn't include it is because it is not a native bird to this area. Islands that are just ahead of us off to our left side will make our way around those. They usually won't be hanging out on them this time of year. However, we can still see some of them netting about April when they are nesting. There's a few of them on there. There was one mother and a couple of young babies on that island. Just off to our left side, out in the middle of the island, we do have 3 of those here. Look straight off to our left there. I'm going to pull up a little bit closer so we can get a better look at them. And they were at the island that is just ahead of us yesterday, so they did make their way over here at some point. Utah cactus is the largest cactus found in the U.S. It can grow as high as a five-story building and is native to the Sonoran Desert. Of those, about 1.5% will survive the first 5 years. The biggest threats to a young Sonoran cactus are freezing, drying out, and being eaten by insects. And growing underneath the small plant helps with all of those things. The cactus requires according to what will give it the best balance, as its other biggest threat is being blown over because they are very heavy. And that's why you'll never see two Sonoran cactus that are exactly alike. They'll all branch in a slightly...
Attend the cruise. What is the age limit for attending the cruise?
So we welcome adults and children of all ages on most of our cruises. However, there are a couple cruises where we do 18 and up, but most of them, all ages.
Is there any special occasions or events that you guys host?
Yeah, we love to do things for holidays, special events, St. Patty's Day, Halloween. We do Mother's Day, Father's Day brunch and dinner cruises that are a huge hit. Right now, we're offering Valentine's Day cruises, and those were almost completely sold out. It's a very popular event.
Tell me, how long has the cruise been around?
We've been operating on the lake since May of 2014, so almost 4 years.
And can you tell me how many people you usually get, like, you know, either per cruise or monthly, yearly, whatever number is easier for you?
It completely depends on the time of year. Right now we're in our busiest time of year, so anything from 50 people a day to sold out, which is 150, and we run anywhere from 1 to 3 cruises a day.
And what are the days and times of the cruises that you guys do?
Right now we're offering our daily sightseeing cruise at 12:30, 7 days a week. How often and how many days a week and what time does change seasonally. And we have sunset cruises on Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays.
How many seasons do you guys have as far as the cruises go? When you say seasonal, what do you mean by seasonal?
Right. So we run year-round, but based on the type of year, we'll cut back or add in cruises. So spring is our busiest time. Summer's pretty busy. Fall's pretty busy. Winter's a little slower, but we host a lot of holiday parties that time of year. So.
As far as holiday events go, do you guys do like parties or like holiday parties on the boat and all that?
Right, yeah, we do private events, so private parties for holidays as well as public events where you can come out, just buy a couple tickets. St. Patty's Day party cruise, Cinco de Mayo party cruise, Halloween party cruise, Valentine's Day dinner cruises, all kinds of different holiday events.
How long is the ride?
So our cruises typically last 90 minutes, so an hour and a half to 2 hours. Our public cruises, and the boat can be chartered up to as long as someone wants to charter it for. We've done 5-hour cruises for weddings and things like that.
And you said the most your popular time of the year to go on a cruise, you said it is the springtime?
Yes, the spring is our busiest time of year. We have cruises 7 days a week, anywhere from 1 to 3 a day.
And what can one expect to see while out on the cruise?
So we often see wildlife while we're out on the cruise. That's really exciting for everyone. We've been seeing our mule deer friends out there a lot lately, including a mama and her two fawn this week, which has been really exciting. wild burrow, bald eagles, a lot of blue heron out there, and other things as well. And obviously the beautiful lake, and in the evenings the sunsets are amazing.
How much does it cost per person, or do you guys have any discounts that you do?
Cruises start at $22 per person before discounts, which we offer senior military discounts for our daily sightseeing cruises, and go up to $65 a person for dinner cruises.
What is the significance behind the name of the ship?
So we just were trying to come up with a name for the boat, and it just came up. I'm honestly not sure who mentioned it first. I think it may have been the builder or his wife, I'm not sure, but they just said the Phoenix. Oh, that just sounds so good and powerful and like just such a great name, and obviously relates to where it's located, so.
As far as food and drink goes, do you guys serve food and drinks and alcoholic beverages on the ship?
We do. We're fully licensed. We have a full bar, so we do beer, wine, cocktails, and we have that available on all of our cruises.
How big is your ship crew?
Our crew typically consists of our captain, a deckhand, and a bartender. Usually we'll have an extra deckhand if we're really busy. Then we also obviously have someone running our ticket office as well, which is typically Pam or myself.
What is the maximum seating on the ship?
We hold up to 150 passengers.
Have you had any cool things happen, you know, while on the cruise, like proposals or things like that?
So we've done a few weddings. So we've had quite a few weddings and receptions, so that's been amazing. No proposals yet, but there's been some people throwing out the idea a few times, so I'm sure it will happen sooner than later.
And tell me more about your spring cruises, your spring music cruises.
So our spring music cruises is a 2-hour sunset cruise with live music by local musicians and a cash bar. We have snacks and a full bar available for purchase on that. And that is just such a relaxing, fun time, ages 18 and up, to come out, have a drink on the water, and listen to some great live music. And beautiful sunsets, as always, in Arizona.
What is your favorite part about working on the cruise ship and being part of the whole experience?
So we're a family business, and we love getting to work together. My mom, my dad, my brother, my grandma, we're all involved in the business. So I love that it feels like a family, because it is a family, and our crew is our family too. So that's my favorite part, and then obviously just getting to be out on the water every day. So
perfect. All right, do you have anything else that you want to add or throw out or?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, cool.
Bye.